Live from the Washington, D.C. area, it's the Colleen and Coco Show News. Today's topic, it's celebrities who might be running for president in 2020. And also, let's not forget our great, great breaking news reporter, Coco Vinia. If there's breaking news, she's there to report it. Hi. Let's get on with the news show. First up on 8 celebrities who might be running for president in 2020, it's Dwayne The Rock Johnson. The Hollywood star and former WWE wrestler was repeatedly hinted at making a presidential run in 2020. Most recently, he told Vanity Fair, "I wouldn't rule it out." When asked if he would make a bid for the highest office, The Rock is a registered Republican voter. If he were to run as a Republican candidate against Trump in 2020, the odds are not in his favor, as no primary challenger has ever defeated an incumbent president of the same party. Speaking of Rocks, next up on our list is Chris Rock, and I'm sure we don't know who any of this man is. Anyways, Chris Rock literally confirmed he was going to run by a tweet on November 2016, stating, "I am going to run in 2020. Wish me luck." Along with a picture, the only thing white is the house. Hashtag Rock 2020. Comedian Chris Rock took to Twitter after Trump's win last week. Well, in November, "I'm going to run in 2020. Wish me luck." Like I said, the post included a Photoshop version of the movie poster for his 2003 film, Head of State, in which Rock played the first African-American president. Well, he'd technically be the second this time, if he were to win. Now, number three, the most popular of the 8 celebrities candidates, I'm guessing you already know, it's Kanye West. While speaking at the 2015 MTV Video Music Awards last August, West concluded his 13-minute monologue by saying, and yes, as you probably could have guessed by this moment, I decided in 2020 to run for president. We all did a face palm. Let's just be honest. In a recent interview with the BBC, the 39-year-old rapper seemed to double down on his bid for the presidency. "When I talked about the idea of being president, I'm not saying I have any political views," West said. "I just have a view on humanity, on people, on the truth. If there is anything that I can do with my time to somehow make a difference while I'm still alive, I'm all for it." Next up is Ron Perlman. I really don't know who this is, but if you've seen the movie Big Fat Liar, he was the bad guy in it. You probably haven't, though. It's kid movie, so. Following Trump's win in November 2016, Hellboy actor Ron Perlman took to Facebook to proclaim, "I am hereby using my immense Facebook presence to announce my candidacy for President of the United States. 2020. Perlman has since posted a series of fake campaign posters, including one that read, "Vote for Pearl or go to H-E-L-L." I cannot say that word. Which he meant by saying, "Should read and go to H-E-L-L." Once again, cannot say that. So, that's an interesting one. I think number 5 on this list, it's Katy Perry. A month after Trump declared his candidacy last year, Katy Perry posted an Instagram photo with former George W. Bush and Bill Clinton. The post included the caption, 42, 43, 46, suggesting that she would run for the president in 2020 or 2024. The pop singer campaigned heavily for Hillary Clinton as part of the deluge of celebrity support that may have hurt Clinton's campaign rather than helped it. Next up, I'm pretty sure it's number six. Will Smith. Actor Will Smith told CBS last year that he may run for president in response to the then candidate Trump's diverse rhetoric. I don't know how to pronounce that word. If people keep saying all these crazy kinds of stuff they've been saying on the news lately about walls and Muslims, they're going to force me into the political arena. He said, I mean, I gotta be the president. What else would I run for? It remains to be seen whether Smith's words will carry on to the 2020 election. And finally, number seven and number eight, they're in it together. They're in it to win it together. Oscar-winning documentary director Michelle Moore, who accurately predicted that Trump would crack the Democrats' blue wall of Midwestern states on his office, has suggested that he left should opt for a well-liked celebrity to run against Trump in 2020. Democrats would be better off if they ran Oprah Winfrey or Tom Hanks. Moore told CNN, following Trump's win, why don't we run, beloved people? We have so many of them. Republicans do this. They run. Ronald Reagan and the Terminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger, and other people. And that's it for today. And that's our sign for breaking news.
Breaking news live from the scene. The Connie, Dan, and Coco show goes to Pennsylvania. Here I will be interviewing Connie.
Thank you for having me, Coco.
Thank you for coming. Are you excited to go on your trip?
Yes, I'm very excited, actually. I love filming with my cousins and Ready, Set, Rock. Link will be in the description below. Also has his own YouTube channel, and I'm hoping that we can do another collab like we did last time.
Are there gonna be any new videos for packing for Pennsylvania?
I don't plan on it, but between the time that we posted our last video, I think it was reacting to cringy musicallys. No, it was Grocery Puns. The time in between Grocery Puns, just for fun, and the shortest night routine ever was 2 months. And I feel like we could make up for that time. So I don't think it hurts to post a lot, but then again, it would be pre-recorded videos also, because I also just upload this week.
Thank you. We'll be back with more questions after this ad.
Did your kids run away because you have knee pain? Well, then what should you do?
I don't know. What should I do?
Well, I know what you should do. Get No More Knee Pain.
How does it work?
You just pop them in your mouth.
Like this?
Exactly.
Do I swallow?
Yes, you swallow, you moron. I bet you don't have any more knee pain.
I don't have any more knee pain.
Do not take No More Knee Pain if you are under the influence of anything bad. Side effects include sneezing, coughing, even worse knee pain, and death.
Wait, what?
I said death. Oops.
So what things are you going to miss most when you go to Pennsylvania?
I'm going to miss 4 things. My family, most of all, my 2 cats, Shelly and Dusty, my really good slime, and the Wi-Fi. Because my grandparents, where we're staying at, does have Wi-Fi, except it's really bad. It's really bad. It's really slow, and then there's like 7 people using it at the time. And it's just bad. It's bad.
That's all the time we have today. Bye.
Thank you for joining us today on the Colin, Dan, and Coco News Show. We hope to see you sometime again soon. Cut. That's a wrap. Peace out.
So, what things are you gonna miss most when you go to Pennsylvania?
I can't edit that out. I can't edit it and make it look clean.
I-N-G-O-V-I-N-G-O. So what things are you gonna miss most in front when you're in Pennsylvania?
Okay. Edit this part out. 3, 2, 1.
Breaking news live from the scene. The Colin, Dan, and Coco Show.
Do it!